Hi, my name is Professor Rodrigo Mendes. As I was born in Brazil in 1974 in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. I was introduced to Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu first in the year of 1995. That's when I was introduced before. I have a couple of friends that trained Jiu-Jitsu, but I didn't have the interest of training. 1995, I started to rule a little bit. In 1996, the first World Games, after I watched the World Games, that's when I really decided to start training Jiu-Jitsu. And I saw, that was the first time that I saw a small guy beating a big guy. I couldn't understand why. It was all about leverage. And that interested me. I want to find out exactly how that happens. That's why I signed up and I really started to learn Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. That was my first school, I'll say, 1996, when I started doing Jiu-Jitsu. I started training under Alliance team, under Professor Alexandre Dantas and Leonardo Castelo Branco. And I trained with them till my brown belt. And through my journey, then 2000, I decided to come to America. I'm still training under them. 2004, I got promoted my black belt under Professor Andre Almeida, the Deco. It was a surprise day. It was a day it's supposed to be a seminar. I just had come from the Pan American Games as a brown belt, where I placed second. And as for my surprise, as we're doing a seminar, I asked him to help me out promoting. I didn't have a black belt present at the day, and I started promoting my students as blue belts and purple belts and brown belts. And then he asked for the words, and Jiu-Jitsu's always been part of my life.
Okay. What is a typical day at Rodrigo Mendes Jiu-Jitsu Academy like?
Here at the school, we like to keep at the school a more as a friendly environment as possible. We do train very hard. We do spend hours on the mats, but we try to keep as fun as possible too. We are like a big family. We joke together. We give nicknames to everybody. And our classes, we start as a regular jiu-jitsu school. We do follow curriculum, and we start as a warming up. We do warm up. We do all kind of different drills. Depends on the curriculum. Depends on the technique that we work on that day. I like to focus the drill into that technique, so we work as a warm-up and works as a technique itself. And then from there we go into a technique, and then we do a specific training. Sometimes if we work on to depends on the class, if you work on a sweep drill, most likely you're going to be doing a specific training for sweeps. If you have a fighter going for a tournament or something, we want to focus on what mistakes he's making, fixing all the mistakes, sharpening all the techniques, and make sure he's ready. For instance, we have about 11 guys flying Wednesday now to California for the World Games, and that's what we focus on right now. We've been working, fixing. We have and bringing in from white belts to black belts to compete in the World Games, and guarantee we're going to be bringing a couple world medals.
Fantastic. Where do you see jiu-jitsu as a sport headed in the future?
I've seen jiu-jitsu growing day by day. When I first moved to America, I'll never forget, I went to Boston, do a seminar in Boston, and as I walked into the supermarket with my pants full of patches with sponsors, people look at me on the street like, what that guy's doing with that pants? They had no idea what jiu-jitsu was. Luckily, I had one Gracie shirt, and a guy, oh, is that Gracie Jiu-Jitsu? But it's nothing like it is today. Today, the way it's growing, it's unbelievable. I go to airports, I'm flying everywhere, and people, like, they stop me, they see Jiu-Jitsu shirts, they associate, they ask me questions, they see cauliflower ears, and they want to find out who I am, if I'm a fighter, if I'm a teacher, what kind of a relationship I have with the sport. And I do see the sports growing a lot. For instance, in my classes now, it's growing the number of women that are signing up for jiu-jitsu classes, and the number of kids, I mean my kids' classes, is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. So I see the jiu-jitsu sports growing just like any other sport.
How is your academy different? What sets RMBJJ apart from other schools?
I guess what sets us different from other schools is pretty much the way we run the show. And here, we don't have, I am the professor, we have other coaches, but everybody's part of the team. We work as a team. So even on my fundamentals class, I have my advanced guys coming in, to help my fundamentals. I don't want to grow one specific athlete. I want to grow everybody as a group. We grow together. I have my kids helping the kids. For instance, the warm-ups on my kids' class, I don't do the warm-ups. They do the warm-ups. They help each other. I see my higher-ranked belts with 7 years old helping the 5 years old, my 13 years old helping the 10 years old, and the respect is mutual. They respect each other. Even when I'm out of the mats, it's still the same respect. That's what I think set us apart from other schools. And we learned the base of the martial arts, the respect, the discipline, and the friendship is all together. But we do train hard.
What can jiu-jitsu fans expect to see from Rodrigo Mendes in 5 years?
I'll say definitely you guys will see a lot of growth, and I'm a professor, I'm not a master, and I like to mention that to everybody that's asking me, so Master Rodrigo Mendes, no, I'm a professor, I'm still learning. I've been doing jiu-jitsu for about 16 years now, and I'll say I didn't even reach like half what I need to learn. I'm in a learning process. Everything that I learn, I share with my students. I still attend seminars. I still going out training with different black belts, different ranks, black belts, helping some world champions to train. So I'm still learning. So I think in years from now, we're still growing. We're growing. The sky is the limit. And we open a new school. We're coming up with a new school now in Boynton. We have a school in Jupiter. We open in a couple months the school in Coral Springs. We have one affiliate school in California. We have one other affiliate school in Croatia, and we're growing. The sky's the limit. All right, Professor Rodrigo Mendes, I want to say, give a shout out for all the Rodrigo Mendes and Gracie Barra Delray Beach fans that follow us on Twitter, that follow us on YouTube, that check the website. Thanks for checking us out. I hope that we are here able to help you guys out, to improve your jiu-jitsu. My whole mindset, my whole goal is how can I help you, my fan, to promote your jiu-jitsu, to improve your jiu-jitsu. And what I mean jiu-jitsu, I don't take jiu-jitsu just on the mats, but I take it in life too. Everything that we do on the mats, I take in life. The good attitude that I have in the mats, I take to the streets. The good attitude, the good friendship that I have in the mats, I bring to the streets. So I want to say thank you so much, you guys, for checking us out. Thank you so much, you guys, for following us. And I hope you guys like it.